Hello friends, welcome to SSP Math channel. Today we are going to start new topic, that is practical harmonic analysis. Now why we study this practical harmonic analysis? What is the use of this in many engineering and scientific problems? Function not given by formula, means mathematical formula, but that function or that data given by numerical values in tabular form. For example, the value of x1, value of y1 for x1 is given, value of y2 for x2 is given. Means, so what is harmonic analysis? Harmonic analysis means the process of finding Fourier series for numerical values is known as harmonic analysis. The process of finding Fourier series for numerical values is known as harmonic analysis. Now if you take, suppose xi yi be the order pair, here I equal to 0 to m minus 1 with the given values such that xi are equispaced in interval 0 to 2L. Means in interval 0 to 2L, suppose xi given a. If I take suppose interval 0 to 2, in 0 to 4, instead of 2 take 0 to 4 say, in 0 to 4 xi given is a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the values of xi. And then respective values of yi is also given in problem. For x1 is equal to, suppose 0, y1 equal to something, x2 equal to 1, y2 equal to something, x3 equal to 2, y3 equal to something, is divided into m equal parts. Means if we divide this xi, yi is into m equal parts. So 0 to 2L, if we divide into m equal parts, then how we find its Fourier series expansion? That is the harmonic analysis. Now we know that the Fourier expansion of y is equal to f of x in the interval 0 to 2L. In 0 to 2L, we already seen the definition of Fourier series, that is y is, if you take f of x is equal to y. So how we write y means how we write the expansion, Fourier expansion of y, that is a0 by 2 plus summation of an cos n pi x by L plus bn sin n by x. So this a0, an, bn are the Fourier coefficients. But given data say xi, yi instead of 0 to 2L, xi, yi given, and then we have to find this Fourier coefficients a0, an, bn. How we calculate? We know a0 can be calculated using this formula, 1 by L integration of 0 to 2L f of x dx. Or if you take f of x is equal to y, then 1 by L 0 to 2L y into dx. So if xi yi is given, then this can be written as, means a0 can be written as 2 times mean value of this y in the interval 0 to 2L. And how we find mean value of y? That is summation of y upon m. So this formula is very important. a0 is equal to 2 times summation of y upon m, where m is number of sub intervals of xi. Then same an is equal to 1 upon L into integration of 0 to 2L f of x cos n pi x by L dx. Or if we take f of x is equal to y, then 1 by L 0 to 2L y into cos n pi x by L dx can be written as 2 times mean value of this function. 2 times mean value of y into cos n pi x by L in the interval 0 to 2L. And how we find mean value means take summation of this. That is 2 times summation of y into cos n pi x by L upon m, where again m is number of sub intervals. So this formula is again important. Similarly, how we find bn? So bn is 1 by L 0 to 2L f of x sin n pi x by L dx. Or if you take f of x equal to y, then 1 upon L 0 to 2L y into sin n pi x by L dx. This can be written as 2 times mean value of y into sin n pi x by L in the interval 0 to 2L. And how we find mean value of y into sin n pi x by L? Using this 2 times summation of y into sin n pi x by L upon m. Again, m is number of sub intervals. So in harmonic analysis, these three formulas are very important. First one is a0. a0 is equal to 2 times summation of y upon m. an is equal to 2 times summation of y into cos n pi x by L upon m. bn is equal to 2 times summation of y into sin n pi x L by L upon m, where m is number of sub intervals. Now what is fundamental? Next one is fundamental harmonic. fundamental harmonic means the term y is equal to, means if we expand this series, this y is equal to a 0 by 2 plus summation of a n cos n pi x by l plus b n sin by n pi x by l for n equal to 1, 2, 3. Then how we write first fundamental? First fundamental is y is equal to a 0 by 2 plus a 1 cos pi x by l plus b 1 sin pi x by l, means for n equal to 1 expand that series. So this is called as first fundamental or first harmonic. The term a 2 cos 2 pi x by l plus b 2 sin 2 pi x by l is called as second fundamental or second harmonic. The term a3 cos 3 pi x by l plus b3 sin 3 pi x by l is called as third harmonic. Now suppose problem A, find Fourier series up to first harmonic. So for that we have to find up to this, means a0, a1, b1. So up to first harmonic, how we write Fourier series? Y equal to a0 by 2 plus a1 cos pi x by l plus b1 sin pi x by l. Suppose question A, find Fourier series up to second harmonic. So up to second harmonic means in second harmonic, first harmonic is already there. So to find y equal to then this a0 by 2 plus a1 cos a pi x by l plus b1 sin pi x by l plus a2 cos 2 pi x by l plus b2 sin 2 pi x by l. And plus suppose question a, find up to third harmonic, then add again this plus a3 cos 3 pi x by l plus b3 sin 3 pi x by l. Dekho students, hame kya karna hai Fourier harmonic analysis mein. सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट है ए जीरो फॉर्मूला. ए जीरो इज इक्वल टू टू टाइम समेशन ऑफ वाई अपॉन एम, देन ए एन इज इक्वल टू टू टाइम समेशन ऑफ वाई इंटू कॉस एन पाई एक्स बाई एल अपॉन एम, एंड बी एन इज इक्वल टू टू टाइम समेशन ऑफ वाई इंटू साइन एन पाई एक्स बाई एल अपॉन एम. अब हमारा प्रॉब्लम होता है फाइंड फूरियर सीरीज अप टू फर्स्ट हार्मोनिक. अप टू फर्स्ट हार्मोनिक आया तो वहां पर हमें ए जीरो ए वन बी वन फाइंड करना है. And how we find this a0, a1, bn? In a0 is this. In an if we put n equal to 1, then we get a1. In bn if we put n equal to 1, then we get b1. Suppose question aya, find Fourier series up to second harmonic. Toh usme hame a0, a1, b1, a2, b2 find karne hai. Up to third harmonic aya toh usme a0, a1, b1, a2, b2, a3, b3 find karne hai. And for all this, we have to use these three formulas. a0, an, and bn. अब इसमें सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट है हाउ वी डिसाइड यल. यदि ये यल समझ में आ गए ना तो कुछ नहीं है हार्मोनिक एनालिसिस में. सो हाउ वी टेक यल? सो एल कैन बी रिटन एज देर आर टू नोट्स. फर्स्ट वन इज इन हाफ रेंज. सपोज प्रॉब्लम इज ऑन हाफ रेंज. सपोज प्रॉब्लम इज ऑन हाफ रेंज फूरियर सीरीज, देन टेक एल इक्वल टू number of observations. In half range Fourier series, take L is equal to number of observations, and in full range Fourier series, take L is equal to number of observations upon 2. So this is very very important, you note this. यदि यल समझ में आया इसमें तो आगे कुछ नहीं है, सिर्फ एल में ही प्रॉब्लम आता है. सो इन सपोज क्वेश्चन है फाइंड हाफ रेंज कोसाइन सीरीज, हाफ रेंज साइन सीरीज. सो टेक द वैल्यू ऑफ एल डायरेक्टली नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशंस. अब ये नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशंस कैसे लेने हम प्रॉब्लम में देखेंगे. फुल रेंज फूरियर सीरीज मीन्स फाइंड फूरियर सीरीज अप टू फर्स्ट हार्मोनिक, फाइंड फूरियर सीरीज अप टू सेकंड हार्मोनिक. यदि ऐसा क्वेश्चन आया तो टेक द वैल्यू ऑफ एल इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशंस अपॉन टू. So when we take this L, if the value of x is given in radian, if L is a value of x is given in degree, don't always take L equal to pi. Okay, now after this, our next concept is, if we find harmonic, first harmonic, second harmonic, third harmonic, that is a1, b1, a2, b2, then sometimes question is there, find the amplitude of first harmonic, amplitude of second harmonic, amplitude of third harmonic. So how we calculate that? Amplitude of nth harmonic is given by under root of an square plus bn square. So suppose question A, find amplitude of first harmonic, put n equal to 1. So amplitude of first harmonic, how we write? Under root of a1 square plus b1 square. Amplitude of second harmonic, how we write? Under root of a2 square plus b2 square, and so on. And similarly, we can find percentage of nth harmonic also. So percentage of nth harmonic can be calculated using this formula: amplitude of nth harmonic upon amplitude of first harmonic multiplied by 100. Suppose question is find amplitude percentage of second harmonic. So for that we have to find A2, B2, A1, B1. After getting A2, B2, find amplitude of second harmonic is equal to under root of A2 square plus B2 square. Amplitude of first harmonic is equal to under root of A1 square plus B1 square. And after getting that values put here, multiply by 100, then we get percentage of second harmonic. Okay, and percentage of first harmonic is always 100%, because n is equal to 1. If you put here, this get cancelled, that is 100. Now we will take one problem. Using tabulated values of x in degrees and y, this is very important here, x in degrees given in. So using tabulated values of x in degrees and y given in the table, obtain a Fourier series up to second harmonic to represent the relation between x and y. अब देखो ये प्रॉब्लम ऑप्टेन फूरियर सीरीज है, मींस ये फुल रेंज का प्रॉब्लम है और एक्स इज गिवन इन डिग्रीज, एक्स यदि डिग्री में गिवन है. देखो फॉर सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन फूरियर हार्मोनिक एनालिसिस कैलकुलेटर इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो सब ने कैलकुलेटर तैयार रखो. अभी उसमें यहाँ पर एक्स की वैल्यू डिग्री में दी है. सो एक्स इन डिग्री गिवन है. सो कैलकुलेटर का जो मोड है वो डिग्री में करो, मोड में जाओ और डिग्री मोड ऑन करो. ओके, नाउ आवर क्वेश्चन है फाइंड फूरियर सीरीज अप टू सेकंड हार्मोनिक यूजिंग दिस डाटा. सो एक्स इज गिवन इन डिग्री. सो वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स गिवन है 0, 30, 60, 90, 120, 150 अप टू सो ऑन 330. एंड रिस्पेक्टिव वैल्यू ऑफ वाई इन फ्रंट ऑफ एक्स इज गिवन इन टेबल. सो हाउ टू फाइंड फूरियर सीरीज अप टू सेकंड हार्मोनिक. सो हियर इंटरवल है 0 to 2L. 0 to 2L given is 0 to 2π. 0 to 2π, how we take 0 to 330, and after 330 360 means 2π. 360 के लिए y की value same repeat होगी 298, इसीलिए वो count नहीं किया है. So 0 to 2L means equal to 0 to 2π, L equal to π. This is one way, means period is 2L here, क्योंकि 2L के लिए 360 के लिए इसकी value आगे repeat हो जाएगी. और सिंपल हिंट है, इफ वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स इज गिवन इन डिग्री देन ऑलवेज टेक एल इक्वल टू पाई. इफ वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स इज गिवन इन डिग्री देन ऑलवेज टेक एल इक्वल टू पाई. नाउ वी हैव टू राइट फूरियर सीरीज अप टू सेकंड हार्मोनिक. सो हाउ यू राइट फूरियर सीरीज अप टू सेकंड हार्मोनिक. फूरियर सीरीज ऑफ वाई, दैट इज वाई इक्वल टू a0/2 प्लस समेशन ऑफ an cos n pi x by l, बट l इज पाई हियर. सो a1 cos nx, an cos nx plus bn sin nx, because if you put l equal to pi, pi get cancel, means first harmonic ke liye a1 cos x plus b1 sin x aega, and second ke liye aage a2 cos 2x plus b2 sin 2x. So for this what we want, we have to find their Fourier coefficients here, a0, a1, b1, a2, b2. Now how we calculate a0? So formula a0 is equal to 2 times summation of y upon m. What is m here? Here m is equal to number of observations. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So m is equal to 12, number of observations. Then an, we know an is equal to 2 times summation of y into cos n pi x by l upon m. Okay, so what we want, we want a1 and a2. So using this we can write a1 is equal to 2 times summation of l equal to pi, put here pi get cancelled, summation of y into cos pi x, summation of y into cos x only upon 12. Okay, and a2 is equal to 2 times summation of l equal to pi, put kiya, pi cancel, n equal to 2 la, y into cos 2x upon 12. Same for b1, what we want, b1 is equal to, for b1, write bn first, bn is 2 times summation of y into sin n pi x by l upon m. So l equal to pi, if you put here, and n equal to 1, then b1, we have to find b1. So b1 is 2 times summation of y into sin x upon 12, and b2 is equal to 2 times summation of y into sin 2x upon 12. So for a0, a1, a2, b1, b2, what we want, For A0, we want summation of y. Now we have to find table. So table is very important for solving the problems on harmonic analysis. So in table, what are the columns? Columns are very important. So first column is the value of x is given in degree. So write down x in degree here. Means we have to write 0, 30, up to so on, 330, right? All values. Then respective values of y, right in front of x. For x equal to 0, y given it 298. So right here 298, then 356 and so on. Okay. After that, how we find now for A1 what we want? For A1 we want for A0 we want summation of y. So write here all values of y and write its summation. This is the summation of y. Okay. For A1, we want summation of y into cos x. So y into cos x. Our next column is y into cos x. So this is first column, x, y. The next column is y into cos x. Y into cos x means take multiplication of this. X equal to 0 put here. X equal to 0 we put here. Cos 0 is 1. So 1 into y, that is 298. Same put x is equal to 30. Find cos 30 and multiply by 356 right here. In this way, find all values and write its summation. Its summation is this. Okay. Then for A2, we want summation of y into cos 2x. So next column is y into cos 2x. Again, yahan par problem aayega sabko. Dekho, hume har x ke liye find karna hai. Means x equal to 0 yahan par put kiya, to cos 0 aayega. Cos 0 is 1 into y, again 298. Uske baad x equal to 30 put karo. 30 into 2, 60 ho jayega. Cos 60 find karo. Cos 60 into 356 जो भी आएगा यहाँ पर ये सब वैल्यूज आपको कौन से मोड में फाइंड करने हैं डिग्री मोड में बिकॉज x इज गिवन इन डिग्री इन प्रॉब्लम x इज गिवन इन डिग्री देन फॉर b1 व्हाट वी वांट समेशन ऑफ y into sin x सो नेक्स्ट कॉलम इज y into sin x एंड फॉर b2 वी वांट समेशन ऑफ y into sin 2x सेम हियर पुट x इक्वल टू 0 sin 0 इज 0 0 into y दैट इज 0 सेम Find all values, write its summation. Then put x equal to again 0, sin 0 is 0, 0 into 0. Then put x equal to 30. Find all values, write summation. Okay. So after this table, we have to find A0. Now what is A0? A0 is 2 times summation of y by 12. Upar already formula likha hai humne. So is equal to 2 times summation of y 2425 upon 12. Isko calculate kiya to A0 ki value ye milti hai. After that A1 is 2 times summation of y into this is A1 2 times summation of y into cos 6 upon 12 to usme value put ki y into cos 6 ki summation ki to wo is 642.296 upon 12 aur isko calculate kiya to ye milta hai uske baad b1 ki jo value hai b1 ke liye 2 times summation of this means 2 times 727.231 upon 12 calculate kiya to ye milega same a2 2 times summation of y into cos 2x use this value divide by 12 then we get this and same for b2 2 times summation of y into sin 2x means 2 times summation of 54.564 upon 12 isko calculate kiya to ye milta hai so these are the values of a0 a1 a2 b1 b2 okay Put all these values in equation 1 and then write final answer. So that is the required Fourier series up to first harmonic. Means if we put these values in 1, then final answer how we write. No space is available here. So we will write here y is equal to a0 by 2. a0 by 2. So what is value of a0? a0 is 404.7 by 2 plus a1 is 107.04 into cos x plus b1 is 121.205 into sin x plus a2 a minus 13 into cos 3x cos 2x and plus b2 a 9.09 into sin 2x. So this is the final answer.